Akasa, and she's very passionate about NQCD. And she's working at the health and the well-being, health and the well-being staff unit within the staffership. And she was an IT manager from South England, but now moving to staff to find super life.
I'm going to talk about mindfulness. I'd like to ask, has anyone heard of mindfulness? Yeah? Has anyone practiced it or tried it? Okay. So there are some people who know what it is, so hopefully you might learn a bit more, and those who don't know about it. So what is mindfulness? Mindfulness is really simply put, it's paying full attention to whatever that you're doing at that present moment. The gentleman who's really brought mindfulness to the fore is somebody called Jon Kabat-Zinn, and he defines mindfulness as paying attention in the present moment without judgment. And it's that last bit that's very important, it's without judgment. So all you do is you become aware of what's happening to your mind and body and everything around you at that point in time. But you don't judge it, you don't say, I like that, or I don't like that, I want less of that, and I want more of that. Because then again, you're bringing your thoughts into it. So mindfulness is awareness, it's just becoming aware of what's happening at that point in time. The purpose of mindfulness really is to be in touch with yourself. Because for a lot of people, myself included, you can be hungry, but you don't realize you're hungry because you're busy doing something. You're thirsty, but you don't realize that you're thirsty until you sit down. So the purpose of mindfulness is to be aware of, at all times, of what you're feeling and thinking and what's going on in your brain. This thing about judgmental is actually quite important, because the whole point of mindfulness is to become curious about what's happening to you. It's not about judging it to be right or wrong, it's just paying more attention to what you're feeling. At the moment, I'm feeling a little nervous because I'm standing and talking here to all of you, and it's becoming aware of that, but then accepting it and saying, that's okay. I'm bound to, not be 100% comfortable because I've got a mic in my hand. I've got people sitting in front of me listening to me. But it's becoming aware of it. And the beauty of it is, once you become aware of it, you actually deal with it a lot better. It's when we're not aware of it and the anxiety starts to rise. Because stress is a part of life, like it or not, especially in today's society. Stress is a huge part of life. The mobile phone never stops. You're always so busy doing 100 things. If you learn to be mindful, because you're always in the moment, you don't actually get stressed. This is the beauty of mindfulness. I've been practicing mindfulness myself since 2005, so it's 11 years now. And I can honestly say it's changed my life. It really has. Because rather than think of the next thing, I'm just focusing on what I'm doing right now. So I'm not letting myself get stressed, because while I'm in the present moment doing what I'm doing, I don't have time to think about anything else. I'm just focusing completely on what I'm doing. So right now, what I want to do is talk to you all about mindfulness, so hopefully you'll learn a bit more. I'm not thinking about what's going to happen in 10 minutes time. So that really is mindfulness. The benefits of mindfulness are huge, and there have been a lot of experiments on it, because I don't know if you're aware, but mindfulness has really moved up the agenda for the government, for the NHS, and this is happening all around the world. So there are a lot of experiments that have been done on people who have been practicing mindfulness for a while. One of the biggest advantages of being mindful is increased psychological resilience, which I think we all need, really, because it's a mindful habit. If you have somewhere dealing with it, which doesn't take long effort, you can only do it quickly. So that, to my mind, is one of the biggest benefits of mindfulness. The other thing that has been found as well, that you don't have to rules, because your mind and body are separate. You're one thing. If you feel calm, if you feel resilient, it affects your body in a really good way as well. And it's actually been proven, people who've been suffering, you know, from all kinds of physical illnesses, like heart trouble, things that you could actually associate with something that you can do by just breathing, because that's what mindfulness really is. We go into that in a little bit. That actually reduces your, you know, your problems with your body. And if you don't have the problems already, maybe if you have it in your family, it's something that you can avoid. So this is why the NHS is really, this is why the NHS has really picked up on it, and it's actually used now as a health tool. What are the other benefits? You have mental flexibility, you have clarity, you have equanimity. I love that word. Equanimity. It just sounds calm, doesn't it? The other thing you love as well is because you are mindful of yourself and your own actions, your relationships improve because you realize it's not all about you. It's about other people as well. It's about the people in your life. It's about the people you live with. It's about the people you work with. You know, your children, your partner, your colleagues, everybody. Because you're more aware of how you feel, it keeps you more in control of how you feel. Your relationships improve as well. And I can, again, I can say this myself because I've been doing it for 11 years. My life has improved no end as I've been practicing mindfulness more and more. So the next question is, how can we be mindful? The best way to start is by paying attention to whatever it is that you're doing. I always suggest to people, because I teach it as well, I always suggest to people, choose an activity that's very short. So say like washing the dishes, or cleaning your teeth, or showering. And try and focus fully on that. Because if you're anything like me, when I'm in the shower, I'm thinking, right, now I'm going to do this, then I'm going to do that, and then I'm going to do that, and then I'm going to be there, and half 10 I'm going to, you know. Instead of that, if you focus completely on how the water, you know, the warm water feels on your skin, the smell of the shower gel, everything about what you are doing at that point. If you're doing the dishes again, your hands are in warm water, it's warm soapy water, it feels good. Cleaning your teeth. Just focus completely on whatever it is that you're doing at that point in time. And what will happen, without any doubt, is your mind will wander, because that's what minds do. Minds are described as either chattering monkeys or as puppies, because that's what they do. They literally go here, there, everywhere. They cannot sit still. And this is why our attention wanders. But mindfulness is a way to train your attention so you keep bringing it back. So you're focusing completely on what you're doing. It doesn't matter if your mind's wandered. And you gently bring it back. And then your mind wanders again. And you gently bring it back. And that is the key. It's being gentle. It's not about beating yourself up. It's not about getting annoyed with yourself, which is again something, you know, that we all of us do. We all beat ourselves up. We all judge ourselves all the time. We speak to ourselves in a way that we would never speak to other people. And it's practicing the opposite of that. It's becoming kinder to yourself. It's becoming gentle with yourself. It's accepting that sometimes we don't get things right. That's okay. It doesn't matter. Try again. So it is that act of gently bringing your mind back to what you're focusing on that develops mindfulness. And like any skill, it has to be practiced. It's not something that you can just start doing and become good at. You have to do it every day. You have to practice. If you learn to drive a car, you can't just get into the car and start driving. It takes a lot of lessons. It takes a lot of practice before you learn to drive. It takes a lot more for you to pass the test. It takes even more practice to become a skilled driver. So that's really the process with mindfulness as well. You have to practice every day. But the good news is you don't have to, it's not difficult. It really is as simple as just focusing on what you're doing. Another way is you might have heard the word meditation. I don't actually like that word because it has so many different connotations. For me, meditation is as simple as just focusing on my breath. All I do is if I get 5 minutes, or if I'm agitated for some reason, I just sit and focus on my breath. And again, the mind wanders, and I just keep bringing back to the breath. That's all it is. It really is that simple. It takes time. That's all. Does it have time? I just wanted to talk very quickly about there are a lot of misconceptions about mindfulness. People talk about mindfulness meditation about achieving some state of bliss, or you know, people use the word nirvana. Well, I'm sorry, that's actually rubbish. There is nothing that you're trying to achieve. All you're trying to do is keep your mind in the present moment. It really is that simple. So if you hear, you know, of people trying to make it out to be something it's not, trust me, it really is simple. The only thing you have to do is practice it, so it takes time. It's not a big fix. Thank you.